Dalla, she was so much part of the public sort of psyche. We were all kind of praying and hoping that she'd be found, and collectively as a nation we all kind of came together behind her parents and hoping that a happy ending would come forward, and unfortunately it didn't. And if there's anything that can kind of help that not happen again to someone else, then I'd like to be part of that.
She was an incredibly together, normal girl from an incredibly together, normal environment. And you really did think, you know, we're not living in Chicago, we're not in downtown, you know, drug land, we're in Surrey.
When you're at school and these people come and visit the school and they always spout the same things out, you know, don't talk to strangers, don't accept sweets, don't accept a lift. And you kind of sit and they go, yeah, yeah, we know that, we know. But, you know, people do, people still do it. And people do get in these cars, and these people are coming into schools and to tell kids these things because they know this happens.
A man stopped in his car and I was really hoping that he'd ask me for directions or something, but he didn't. He asked me if I wanted to lift home, and I said no thank you because I'd never seen him before in my life. And then he quite aggressively said, get in the car. And I said no, and luckily enough for me, my friend lived two doors away. So I just ran to his house and like as quick as I could, but I was really scared.
When you are going on a journey, you know, try and make sure that you either phone or you text your parents when you get there, or let somebody else know. You know, when you do arrive at the destination, you know, text them, say I'm here, okay. You know, then people can relax, and you know, it makes it a lot easier. You know, especially now with kids, you know, they've all got the mobile phones and that. You know, so put them to good use.
Something that my mum always used to say to me was, if you feel in any way slightly intimidated or uncomfortable, it's something that's just not quite right, then don't think with your head, go with your gut.
When I was on the train back from Upminster with my mates, the train was full of West Ham fans, and they were, like me being an Arsenal fan, they started chatting at me and pushing me and that, and I just was really scared.
Some guys had followed me off the train, they'd seen I was texting, they'd seen my phone, it was a new phone. And I come out the station and I had my Walkman on, it was dark, and they followed me up the hill. And in the end I did end up getting mugged and it was quite nasty, and you know, they were kicking me and things like that. But I could have actually stopped it. I mean, little things like walking to the nearest house, as if it's your house, would probably throw them off. Or going up to someone, or I mean, probably the best thing would be not to have had the Walkman on in the first place.
I would bore people stupid about where I was going to be, and I'd get a great kick out of that. Like, family and friends would say, right, even when I was, like, a youngster, it ain't that long ago, I'd always let someone know where I was going, whether it was just going to play football, whether it was going to the shops, whether it was just going to the pictures. I'd say, right, I'm going to pictures. They'd go, yeah, all right, we know. Yeah, but I'm going to pitch and it starts at 7, so I'll probably be out about 9.30, all right? Yeah, all right, we know. It might be 9.30 or 10 o'clock, but if I'm not, you'll be the first. And I used to get great fun out of boring them stupid. And that way, that they knew when I was coming back.
The path I am taking will always be my own. Time's clear, time's unknown. Steps I am walking without a hand to hold. One day we're all alone, and I'll take the words you gave me. I hear them clearly. What you told me is always with me. When you
I'll tell you what all 14-year-old girls are like, but I can speak for me. I guess I'm pretty normal, whatever that means. I mean, I always like to fit in, and I hate it when everybody looks at me as if I'm different. And then I like to be noticed sometimes. I don't like mornings, I don't like estate agents, or the fact we have to sell the house. I like my friends, and I like magazines, but don't believe everything they tell me. Which is just as well. I worry what people think, but my mum says that we can't change the world. My mum says lots of things. I think we can change the world.
Delivery.
There's no one in.
Sorry?
Everyone's gone out.
I've got a parcel here for a Mr. Alan Granger. I just need someone to sign for it.
He's not here.
Yeah, well, if you could just sign for it, love.
He doesn't live here anymore.
Hello? Is there somewhere I could leave it for him? Hello? Hello? I'm just trying to do my job here. Thanks very much, yeah? I just hope it's important.
What?
My dad doesn't have a mobile.
Your dad doesn't live 100 miles away.
Wish he did.
Shut up, Claire.
I do, though.
Oh, Stanley said we should meet up after school.
What for?
I don't know. Study project.
We should have said we weren't prepared to work with boys.
Stanley's all right. I mean, he's a bit weird. But he's all right.
Talking of weird. Good morning, Zoe. I'm fine, thanks for asking.
Great project we're gonna have, you, me, her and Stanley.
You work with her brother though.
Beat Stanley any day.
What are you doing, Stanley?
Nothing. Just practicing. It's not turned on.
Don't. I don't like it.
It's not turned on.
I don't care. Don't point it at me.
I got it from home for the project, so we don't have to use the school one.
I'm not doing it anyway.
Don't be like that again. Look, we've got to do it. You've got to do it, Zoe. I've already started filming.
I don't have to do anything. Turn it off, Stanley.
Look, I booked the computer room. We've got half of lunch and the whole of after school. I'll show you my ideas and my visions. What am I going to tell Amy?
And watch as the cheeky little scamp skips and ambles its way to school. If it had a name, we'd call it laughter.
You want to meet up after school then, Rabbit?
You are?
Is she going to do it now?
Who?
Zoe.
Better be a good idea.
She'll come round. She has to.
Why are we meeting at lunchtime?
She's never come round before.
Stanley?
What?
Why are we meeting? What's the point?
The film?
I thought we all had to agree.
Yeah, but still.
Do me. Make me look beautiful.
Pardon?
Make me look beautiful.
It's a video camera, not a miracle worker.
Shut up, Claire. Stanley?
Hello, fans. Welcome to our film project. My name is Amy Granger, and this is my best friend, Claire.
Hi, Mum.
Say hello, Stanley.
Hello.
We are filming a documentary on our lives and who we are.
Are we?
Our project will be the best in the year.
Our project won't get started because there's a traitor in our team.
Despite Zoe Taylor, we must and will win.
Zoe Taylor is a frigid cow who won't take part because she's scared of looking stupid.
Oh, it's not fair. Nobody likes me.
Oh, I'm Zoe Taylor. Don't look at me because I'm a freak.
Zoe, you're so ugly. Please stop frightening the children.
Oh, I wear black and red socks and think they look good.